Your digital SLR camera has got all sorts of tools in it to help you focus. They're called autofocus modes. Unfortunately, manufacturers haven't yet standardized what they call all these different things, even though they all do pretty much the same thing. On my Nikon, for example, I have continuous, single and manual mode to control how the actual focusing bit is done. On a Canon, it will be called auto intelligent servo or something like that. You're just going to have to get your book out and look up autofocus modes, and that's where you're going to find how to control it on your camera. But actually what they do is pretty much the same on all of them. Now let's start at the beginning. If you've just bought a digital SLR camera, there's a pretty good chance it's going to be on fully automatic focus. Now that's okay, but the trouble is the camera doesn't know what you want in focus and what you don't. Let me show you what I mean. On the back here, this little set of buttons here, this allows me to tell the camera where I want the camera to focus, what area in the screen I want to use. If you're on fully auto, which is that top one here, the camera is completely in charge. Now I've got some nice little leaves up here. Here we go, they're beautifully backlit, and I'm going to take a picture of these leaves small in the viewfinder using the building on the other side of the plaza to as a background. Now if I try and focus, yeah, straight away the camera is focusing on the building. It doesn't know that I want these little leaves, which are quite small up in the left hand corner of the picture, to be the subject of the shot. It thinks I want that great big building over there, which I don't. Now how do you control that? What do you do about it? If you flick it into the dynamic mode, as it's called on the Nikon, this means I can choose a little dot inside the viewfinder, and I can roll that dot around the viewfinder by using this multi-directional button on the back of the camera, and I can see through the viewfinder it moving around all over the place. So I can choose where to put it. Now I'm going to choose the spot up in the top left hand corner because that's where my leaves are. The camera will look at that little spot and it will choose a cluster of points around it, and that's where it will focus. So let's go back to my leaf. Here it is. Let's put the dot on the leaf. Bam! Straight away my leaf is in focus and the building behind is all soft and out of focus, which is what I wanted to achieve. There's another very similar area focus mode called single point. That's the one at the bottom down there. Very much the same as the dynamic. I can choose a point and I can move it around the viewfinder. But instead of it also focusing on a cluster of points around the one like it does in dynamic, it only focuses on the point that I have chosen. Great for pinpoint accuracy in a portrait or something like that. I could use it on my leaf. Thing to be careful with whenever you do this is not to move. You need to focus your camera and take the shot straight away, because if you focus and then you wait for a minute, you could just rock backwards and forwards only that much, and particularly with a close-up, you're going to blur your own picture. You're going to knock it out of focus.